all of us in today's time is how can you know we all or majority of us do realize the importance of meditation, but somehow we are not able to put it in practice. We are not able to do it daily. And there is some solution which will be offered, some tips which will be definitely given to make sure that it becomes a part of our daily life. And somewhere the aspiration is to do two bigger session, 1 hour, 2 hours, what we have heard. But in a modern day context, the consistency is more important, and a quality or a short practice can give amazing results, which may not come with long meditation done for a shorter period of time. So then we will do an actual demo of a meditation session, and then we'll share about the live program, a monthly program which we have developed. We'll work on that, and we'll cover the questions you may have. So I would like to today introduce the our speakers. Sudipta Shanbhag is there. She is a practicing, she's been practicing yoga since early teens, and have a very unique blend of experience of having work on in biomedical engineering, and being a very deeply knowledgeable about yogic practices, and a very well trained and experienced teacher. So getting, because she then understands the challenges of a modern day people, how they're facing having lived that life, and how she has also using the yogic practices to tackle that. So wherein yoga become an actual important tool to manage their day-to-day stresses and challenges which we are facing. She will be she's one of the main meditation teachers with Eka, and as well as yoga teacher. So she will be there throughout the journey. And I think Priyanka will also be joining. She's a co-founder of Eka Meditation, and she will be there to answer some of your queries. So with this, I would like to hand over the session to you, Sudipta. So over to you.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this session. And I actually wanted to get an idea about why all of you are here. So if you can type in the chat box, or I just want to know why you are looking for a meditation practice while I'm talking. So you can just type it out. So first of all, there are so many different yogic practices, right? So this there is asana, there is pranayama, there is meditation, there are different types of meditation, there's yog nidra, there is japa, so many different techniques are there. And like Ankur was saying, sometimes we just get so caught up in learning technique after technique. We really forget the point of doing the practice. And the point really is to kind of move from this chaotic state of mind that we have. There's so many things happening around us. We have our family life, we have our careers, we have so many different things. And sometimes it just kind of overwhelms us. And the practice itself will help us to bring focus and to go from this state that the world is in into this state, where everything is happening around us, but we are able to maintain that calm and serene state, and we can take our decisions thoughtfully without getting carried away by our emotions. So this is sort of the key point of doing a meditation practice daily. So let me say there are a few answers in the chat box. Want to experience to reduce stress and to improve sleep quality. Excellent. So yes, these are some of the things. And probably some of you have also have come for stress, like one person has mentioned. It's also a very complementary kind of other issue that a lot of people are facing right now, and that is anxiety. For mental calmness, to let go of the past, and for peaceful life. Yes. So all of these kind of hint at the fact that we are a little bit anxious, we are a little bit caught up in our life where we are not able to find that clarity of a thought. You know, if you see the lake, if you drop a small little stone or not even a pebble, just a little leaf, if you drop, you see the ripples that are created. Similarly, in our mind also, the same thing happens. A thought enters, something happens in our life, and then everything else gets the ripple effect of that one thing entering our mind or entering our life. So how do we find that peace is the question. Natra, I think you can just type your question because it'll, you know, the flow of the session will get interrupted if I ask you to unmute and talk. And I'll take the questions as we go along. So the way to get here to this peaceful state is to build a daily habit of meditation. Now, a lot of people join some class, they'll do it for a few days, whenever they can, once or twice a week perhaps. And they say, okay, I'm not really getting the benefit. And the main thing is you have to practice daily. Every single day, you have to build that habit. What is it that this practice gives us? So this practice can be done for so many different benefits. We start with releasing the physical tension in the body. Now, if I ask some of you, you know, what do you feel after going for a walk or after going for a swim or cycling or whatever practice that you do after doing yoga, asana perhaps? What is it that you feel? Is it just a physical release of tension, or do you also feel good and relaxed in the mind? Even a simple walk, 10-minute walk, what is that which changes? Have you all noticed that when you go for a walk, you feel relaxed? So the relaxation comes because of the mind-body connection. When the body relaxes, the mind also gets an opportunity to relax and let go. One of you mentioned you want to let go. So that letting go of stress happens partly by starting with the body. In yoga, we have the system of looking at the body as five layers. We have the koshas. So you have the annamaya kosha, which is the physical body. Then you have the breath body, which is the pranamaya kosha. And then we have subtler layers of our being, the mind body, the manamaya kosha. We have the vijnanamaya kosha, the intellect. And then we have the anandamaya kosha, or the bliss body. So we're trying to kind of integrate all of these layers into one practice. Whether you're doing asana or pranayama or any of these, the idea is to sort of bring unity, bring resonance, and bring clarity through all the layers of our being. So we start with physical release of tension. Then we think about how to balance the nervous system. One of the easiest ways to balance is to do breathwork practices. So pranayama means to increase the prana, the life force in the body. And it can be done through many ways, but the easiest, like I said, is to do breathing exercises, to do breathwork practices. So that is the second step. Then we can, you know, after that nervous system is balanced, we are able to see more clearly. We can start recognizing the patterns of our mind. And that will give us so much insight into how we are, how do we function, who are we. And once you can recognize those patterns, you can start changing the ones that you want to let go of. And then you will notice that every other aspect of your being will also get addressed. And one of you mentioned sleep, improve the quality of your sleep. So that is one of the best things about doing a daily meditation practice. You will be able to improve your sleep cycle, because obviously once the stress level, anxiety level goes down, it is natural for the body to be able to relax, to be able to fall asleep. So all these issues of not being able to fall asleep or not being able to stay asleep, or you're sleeping, but when you wake up, you feel tired and you feel exhausted. So those things will start getting addressed with a daily practice. Okay, so before we move on with the slides, I want to do a very short practice. It's called Tense and Relax. That way, I will be able to help you experience that mind-body connection. Okay, so let's start. A couple of requests for talking in Hindi. I'm sorry, this session is going to be in English. We may be able to organize one in Hindi later on. Okay, so let's start by sitting comfortably. You can be in a chair like I am right now or on the floor. This practice will help release physical tension. And if you have anxiety or if you have a lot of stress, it's been shown to relax every layer very, very quickly. It's almost like an instant release. So bring your hands out in front of you and make tight fists with your hands. Squeeze your hands, wrists, forearms, elbows, upper arms, and hunch your shoulders. Squeeze your arms as tightly as you can. Hold that tension and try to feel the sensations coming from your arms. When you can't hold any longer, simply breathe out, open out your fingers, relax the hands in your lap, and try to feel the sensations coming from your hands and arms. Some of you may be feeling warm. Some of you may feel some tingling sensation. Try to observe that. Good. Now, similar to what we did with the arms, we're going to do the whole body all together. So stretch your legs out in front of you and squeeze your toes, squeeze your feet, ankles, lower legs, knees, thighs, hips and buttocks, the belly, the chest, the entire back, the arms. And don't forget the face. Try to make a tight, squeezing expression with your face as if you've eaten something sour. And squeeze and hold this tension all through your body, from your toes all the way up to your head and face. You can keep breathing if you have high blood pressure. Otherwise, you can hold your breath just a couple more seconds. Squeeze out all the tension. And relax and let go. Allow your facial muscles to soften. Allow your neck and the shoulders to relax. Relax your arms, hands. Relax your belly. It's very important to relax that area. Relax the whole back and your legs, your toes. And now take a few easy breaths to help you let go further. Breath by breath, allow the body to relax more. And slowly, when you're ready, open your eyes. So I hope that you were able to feel some relaxation. You can share your experience in the chat box. So this is a very simple illustration of the connection between the body and the mind. Just a small 2 minute, not even 2 minute practice, and how refreshed we feel after that. Especially if you've had a trigger, especially if you're feeling anxious or if something has just happened and you have this tightening sensation, squeeze and relax, let go. That will help you to go further into a state of relaxation. Now, the interesting thing about this practice is when you were doing it, when I was instructing it, you were probably not able to think of anything else. You're concentrating on the sensations coming from your body. You're trying to tighten as much as you can, and you're feeling it. You're totally present and aware of that moment by being in it. And this is the practice of mindfulness. So mindfulness is a Western term that has been coined to be present in the current moment. But in our yogic system, we have 8 limbs. So it's a long process. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, and Samadhi. So these are the 8 steps that will help you go into that state of calm and serene, being able to see with clarity. So to reach that, we did now a practice of tense and relax, that is with the physical body. But in the meditation classes, I was telling you about the 5 koshas. We're going to address all of those layers of our being through the practice. I see some message in the window. Rigidity has reduced. Yeah, you feel that relaxation and that release, the softness coming into the body after a practice like this. And similarly, asana practice also does the same thing. So our 20-minute daily classes with Eka start with a very short movement practice, just about 4 minutes or so. And that will set you up for meditation. I wanted to talk about what are some of the things that people are afraid of, or what are the things that people give as excuses to not come for a class, for a meditation class. Firstly, the thing is, I don't have time for it. I'm a student, I have so much stuff to do, I'm working, I don't have time for meditation, or whatever it is. Different people in different stages of their life give different excuses. All of it relates to time, that they don't have enough time. Well, it's not a one-hour class that we're talking about, just 20 minutes. And anyone can make 20 minutes in a day. The other part is, the timing doesn't suit me. So to address that, we have timings all through the day. We have 7 a.m. in the morning, 11:30 in the morning, 3 in the afternoon, and then in the evening, we have 6:30 as well as 7:30 class. So these are this gives you the flexibility to join whenever you can through the day. And ideally, you should join the same time every single day, so that your mind also gets used to the routine. Just like how, you know, you wake up in the morning and you brush your teeth. It's not like one day you're waking up and brushing, second day you're doing it after breakfast, right? Every day you do it at the same time. You get up and then you associate getting up with brushing. Similarly, you associate one particular time slot in your day to the meditation practice. So after about 10-15 days, what happens is the brain will remind you, hey, it's time for the meditation. So then, you know, you get into that routine, and then you can reap the long-term benefits of the practice. Doing it once or twice will give you short-term, just temporary relief. But when you do it for weeks at a time, months at a time, deeper layers of your being start getting affected. And people around you will also start noticing, oh, you're looking very calm nowadays. You're not reacting to situations so much. You seem to be a little more steady. So why is that happening? Because of the meditation practice. Voice is echoing. Is that happening for everyone? I think so. Okay. All right. So this is the this is to do with the movement. Now, let me talk a little bit about the breath. Our breath is deeply interconnected with our nervous system. Okay. So when you are in an excited state, the body goes into a fight or flight mode. So if there is, in the old days, if there's a tiger in front of you, you have to either fight the tiger or you have to run away from it. So the brain says, okay, now it's time to get active. It sends the blood to the limbs, to your legs and to your arms, so that you can get away from that place, or you can fight the predator in front of you. What is the opposite of it? The opposite is when you are relaxed. Imagine yourself sitting in your favorite chair or sofa, drinking your tea or coffee or water. And what is that feeling that you have? You have a feeling of rest and digest, just relaxation. So these are the two aspects of our nervous system. And most of the time in our daily life now, we are constantly stimulated. So either our phone is telling us something, or the TV is telling us something, or there is some other news that comes in, activities that are happening around us in our neighborhood. Of course, there's a lot of scare coming from different areas, people about different things that are happening, the different viruses, versions, etc. So all of these are kind of stimulating us, and the body is, you know, reading those stimuli as if a tiger has come in front of us. But really, it's not something that we need to go into fight or flight mode for. We should be able to just sort of say, okay, yeah, this is happening here, but I'm going to take an informed decision on how I want to respond to this. Most of the things in our life don't really need us to actively fight something or run away from something. It's all just a stimulus that has come in through our eyes, through our ears, something that we have smelled. So we can usually just respond to it instead of reacting. How do we make that shift? The shift happens with a breathwork practice, by doing pranayama. And pranayama, like I said, is a very direct connection to our nervous system. So breathing through your right nostril versus your left nostril has a completely different effect on our system. Breathing slowly versus breathing fast, again, very different responses. If you are breathing really fast, suppose you have an exam coming up or an interview and you're really scared, you can just kind of remember that moment, right? Everything kind of becomes like you're breathing faster and shallower, and you feel so unnerved. You completely are out of your regular state of mind. So that can be changed by simply doing a short abdominal breathing practice, which we will be trying today in our demo session. Or, you know, there are so many different techniques. Of course, Nadi Shodhana is there, Bhramari Pranayama is there, Ujjayi Pranayama is there. All of these can help us bring ourselves back to balance, to bring us to our rest and digest aspect. Okay, so that's about breathwork practices, so that we can reduce our emotional response to situations. Now, the question is also, why Eka? Why do we want to practice in our classes? Why is Eka different? First of all, you have experienced teachers, excellent teachers, who have been themselves practicing for a very long period of time. It's not like somebody is reading out a script from a book, right? It's someone who's talking with experience. You can discuss and understand how the techniques are going to help you. Someone is guiding you throughout. Unlike, you know, just playing a YouTube video where somebody is talking and you're just listening, but there is no interaction. If you have a question, who's going to answer it? Of course, YouTube also has all these ads in the middle, which completely takes you out of your meditative state. You're, you know, right there after 3 minutes, some ad starts playing, and then you're thinking about the food that the ad is talking about. So all of this will not be there. Experienced teachers, and we know what we're doing. So we have designed these classes to help you get the maximum out of those 20 minutes. And the idea is for you to get that stepping stone to build a habit, to build that regular practice. I would like to now just help you experience that session, 20 minute meditation practice. So I'll stop the sharing, and I'd like all of you to kind of find a position in your house or wherever you are, where you can be sitting comfortably, either on the floor or in a chair. And I'll also move down to the floor now. Give me a moment. So sitting comfortably, getting ready for a very short practice of meditation. Adjust your body till you feel comfortable and balanced. Now, for some of you, sitting on the floor may look like this. So if this is happening, that probably means that there's some tightness in the hips. It could be different reasons. But one of the ways to help you sit more comfortably is to just simply separate the knees a little wider. That way, your hips will be more comfortable. And the second thing that you can do is place a pillow under your hips. When your hips are a little bit more raised, then the body can be more comfortable. So try one of these two options or both of these options, separating your knees a little wider or placing a pillow under the buttocks. Once you've adjusted yourself, lengthen your spine as if someone is drawing you up from the top of your head. And the last thing we'll do is adjust the position of the hands. You can slide the hands closer to the knees and then closer to your body. And just find a spot where your arms and shoulders can relax completely. Bring your index finger and thumb to touch in chin mudra. And press very gently with the back of your hand into the thighs so that you can sit up straight. All of this should be very minimal effort. Now gently close your eyes and become aware of your breath. Is your breath fast or slow? Try to notice. Notice how you feel at this moment before the practice. Is the mind busy, or are you feeling quite comfortable? Let's start by chanting Om together once. You can join if you like, or simply listen. Take a deep breath in now. Feel the vibrations. With a few blinks, gently open your eyes and release your hands down. One of the deterrents to a meditation practice is that people feel uncomfortable while sitting for the practice. So let's do a few movements to relax the hips, relax the shoulders and the neck and spine. Okay, we'll start with the hip movement. Bring the soles of the feet together and draw your feet closer to your hips and begin to move your knees up and down. You can go fast or slow. And feel the sensations coming from your inner and outer thighs. And slowly come to stillness. Breathe in and lengthen your spine. Breathe out and bend forward. Exhale. Continue to breathe here, feeling the stretch in the inner thighs. 4, 3, it should feel like a gentle relaxing stretch, 2, and 1. Slowly inhale and rise up. And now something very similar. Here we have stretched out the inner thighs. Now I'll show you a small variation which will help stretch the outer hip, especially for those of you who tend to walk or do running. It will help. So walk your feet away from you, creating a big rhombus shape, a big diamond shape with your legs. Now hold your shins and breathe in. Lengthen your spine and breathe out, hinge and bend forward. Notice how this stretch shifts to the outer hip and outer thighs. If you're not feeling it, then you probably have to move your feet further away. Hold for 5. Keep breathing. 4, 3, 2. Keep observing the sensations and stay connected with your body. Last one. And slowly inhale and rise all the way up. Place your hands back behind you and stretch out your legs. Relax them. And then slowly adjust yourself back into your seated posture. Sukhasana, cross-legged, or a little bit wider. This is called Dhyanasana, with the knees wide apart. Either of them will do. Now, one movement for your neck and the spine. Bring your left hand to the right knee and the right hand behind you. Now, lengthen your spine as you breathe in. And as you breathe out, rotate your body towards the right. There should be no strain, just a sensation of gentle stretching. Continue to breathe. 3 more. Observe that twist in the spine. 2, and 1. Slowly unwind and return to center. And let's do the other side to balance it out. Right hand on the left thigh, left hand behind you. Breathe in and lengthen. And breathe out, twist the body. 5, keep breathing. 4, try to stay aware of the sensations coming from the belly, coming from the chest and shoulders, and from the neck. Good, one more here. And slowly unwind, returning back to center. A last movement, drop your right ear towards the right shoulder. Feel the stretch in the left side of the neck. Inhale, rise up to center. Exhale, go the other side. Come back up. Move from right to left at a pace that is comfortable for you. And when you're done with this round, return to center and readjust your body. We'll move on to our pranayama practice, a breath work. Today we'll be doing abdominal breathing. If any of you have lower back pain, if you're not able to sit comfortably for a long period, you can lie down in Shavasana and then bend your knees and place the feet on the floor like this. And then you can have one palm on the belly, one palm on the chest. Feel the natural rhythm of your breathing. Those of you who are comfortable and seated, continue as you are. One hand on the belly, one hand on the chest. Just notice the natural rhythm of your breathing. Notice how the belly and the chest expand and contract. Some of you may feel it more in the belly or more in the chest. Be aware of that without any judgment. We're now going to deepen the breath. As you inhale, expand your belly like a big balloon. And as you exhale, allow the air to escape naturally. Feel the belly drawing in towards the spine. Inhale, expand your belly like you're inflating a balloon. And slowly let go of the air, emptying. And at the very end, draw the belly in. Inhale, expand, smooth and slow, as slowly as possible. Once you reach full capacity, begin to exhale. When you're done with the exhale, begin the inhale again. And just notice if your chest is moving. Try to keep your chest still. Only the belly moves out and in. This is called abdominal breathing. It's one of the most relaxing practices. Continue by yourself for a few more rounds. Make the breathing smooth. The mind gets distracted, recognize what has happened and slowly come back. Come back to abdominal breathing. If you feel dizzy, you're probably breathing too fast. Slow down the breath, relax for a few moments. Just one more round, inhale and expand. Go up to full capacity without moving the chest, without straining. And then begin to exhale, letting go of the breath gently. And at the very end, draw the belly in to empty a little more. And now let go of abdominal breathing. Go back to your natural rhythm and pace of breath. And you have an option now to either lie down in Shavasana, stretching out the legs, arms by your thighs, or continuing in your seated posture. Adjust your body till you feel centered, balanced, where you're neither leaning forward nor back, neither right nor left. Completely in alignment with the force of gravity. say to yourself mentally, for the short duration, I can and I will be still easily. Now take your awareness down to your feet without moving them. Simply observe the sensations coming from your feet, the toes, soles of the feet, tops of the feet, heel, and the ankles. And consciously relax them. When you relax, there may be a little bit of movement, that's okay. Calf muscles and the shins. Observe and relax. Knees, kneecaps, and the back of both your knees. Back of the thighs. Soften. Notice if the mind begins to drift. It's okay. Stay alert and immediately bring your mind back to observing your hips and buttocks, improving your focus. Relax the hips and buttocks. And feel both your legs together, grounded and relaxed. Observe your torso now, starting with the lower belly. Many times we tend to hold unconscious tension here. So relax all the abdominal muscles so that your breath can flow freely. Let the natural breath pace continue. Try not to interfere. Relax the chest. And the entire back, lower back, middle back, and the upper back. The torso is relaxed. Now the arms, starting with the fingers. Feel all your fingers, the curve in the fingers, the sensations coming from them. Palms, back of the hand, wrists. Feel both hands together. Soften. Feel the rest of the arms, the forearms, elbows, upper arms, shoulders, and armpits. Try to relax and let go of all effort. Neck, scalp, and the face. Consciously relax the eyes, allowing them to sink into their sockets. Check if the mind has drifted to think of other things. Bring it back. Relax your jawline and your tongue. And now feel the whole body centered, still, and relax. Within the stillness of your physical body, observe the gentle movement of the breath without interfering. Like a witness. and breathing in and breathing out. Acknowledge each breath mentally. Keep coming back to the breath each time the mind drifts. This is the practice of building the focus. And breathing in and breathing out. No matter what chaos is going on around us or even within us, we can always focus our mind on the breath to reconnect with that stillness, that silence within. Now notice how you feel at this moment. After doing breath awareness, if you're lying down, you can slowly begin to move the body, roll to your side, and take your time to come up to a seated position. Be very gentle. Those of you who are already in the seated position, check in with your posture. Notice if you've started hunching. Try to straighten up. And mentally note how the practice was for you today. What was the state of the mind? Notice if you start judging by adding the word good, bad. Try to simply observe for what it is. The mind was distracted, the mind was steady. How was it for you? And now let's seal the class by chanting Om together once. Join your hands in front of your chest and take a deep breath in. Om. Rub your hands together briskly. Feel the warmth being generated. Place that warmth against your eyelids and your face. Bowing down to Mother Earth in gratitude and for her blessing. With a few blinks, very slowly open your eyes with a big smile. Welcome back, everyone. So I'd like to hear from you on how the practice was for you and what your experience was. You can type in the chat box. How do you feel now when you compare it to the beginning of class? Was it relaxing? How was the breath work? Was it easy? So each of these sections, the movement practices at the beginning, the breathing exercises, all of them, you can start going deeper and deeper into the practice each time you go in. So today your abdominal breathing may have been 3 seconds long for the breath. Slowly you can start deepening the breath even more and make it longer duration. And you'll see the benefit of how your normal breath during the day changes simply by doing these practices through the day. Thank you, Rajshekar. I'm glad you were able to relax. Very soothing. Yeah. Good. Thank you, Asha. Relaxation in the upper back. Yeah. Many times we tend to hold tension in the neck, shoulders, the lower back region, the hips. So a simple practice like this can make a world of a difference. And it's just 20 minutes long. So I'd like to actually hand it over to Ankur, so you know we can talk about the different practice, the different plans that we have, and the offer we have for you today, and the timings that we have of the classes. Like I was saying, we have multiple classes through the day, and they're all 20 minutes long. And depending on the type of person you are, someone mentioned that they wanted to improve their sleep quality. We have a Yog Nidra class at 3 in the afternoon, which is going to be really great to help you to relax and let go. And it helps the night sleep improve. Whether you do it early in the morning or in the afternoon, the night sleep increases, or the quality of the sleep improves when you do Yog Nidra practice. Actually, Ankur is a long-term practitioner of Yog Nidra, so he can vouch for that too. So thank you for all the feedback, everyone. I'm glad that you were all able to enjoy the session. Ankur, over to you.
Yeah, thanks, Sudipta. It was a wonderful session as always. So I, myself being a subscriber to Eka app, and so it's almost, you know, on daily basis, virtual, you know, through the app, I get to experience Sudipta's teaching. So they're very precise, and yes, even in the meditative practices also, they're very powerful. Can you switch off the music, Sudipta? So as you know, Sudipta shared that that it's the consistency, the real benefit of the meditation comes with daily practice. And the biggest challenge for all of us is how to, you know, get into that habit of daily practice. And that's how Eka team conceived, because they had a lot of stuff which was pre-recorded via their app. But they realized that many of their customers came back and they wanted a live program to get into that habit. And obviously for all of us, the biggest challenge is time. We have our office work or household work or children, different responsibilities. So they even came up with they structured it in a manner that none of the customers have an excuse that, okay, they can't do it, you know, at the time. So it's almost, you know, 5 sessions in a day at different times, which is being offered from morning, you know, 2 or 3 sessions to 1 in, you know, afternoon, then evening, you know. So you can't have an excuse. If your real intention is to do meditation and you want a live teacher to be there with you, then you should not have an excuse that you don't have that opportunity or time which doesn't suit. And other, you know, common thing which I have seen is people say, okay, meditation, there is a lot of free content which is available. Okay, I can go to YouTube, or I can go, and get that access. Why should, you know, we do these, you know, practices or have a subscription based thing? So it's like, as I said in the beginning, it is an investment for your lifelong health. And then second thing is when you have a live teacher, and with every session, they have a 10-minute Q&A option. So you can clarify or have that any doubt you may have or clarity you need. So the best teaching is actually live teaching. And when you have teachers like, you know, Sujita, they have almost more than 8, you know, highly experienced and qualified yoga and meditation teachers who will be coming there, that each one of them taking different sessions. So you will have different teachers, their experience to tap into. and to make sure that you know you actually get the practice, and a live coach in a way, a meditation teacher is there to make sure you're getting the benefit of the practice. And by turning up for these sessions, you are not missing an opportunity. So that is there. And Karishma, can you move on to slide in terms of the content? Which is there. The timing and other things. Yeah, so that is fine. And one more slide where we have listed the different timings. Yeah, so you know, in the session, we'll be having 20 minutes of class, which will be there. In some session, you will have stretching and pranayama as well. And depending upon the session, different form of practice. So it's not a one type of meditation; it's an integrated practice which is being offered. So that is there. And then the next slide. Yeah, so these are the, six, I think now it's five because of the winter season. So there are, it's being offered at 7 a.m. in the morning, 11:30. Then I don't know, it's zoomed at my end or can you reduce the zoom? Karishma, can you reduce the zoom of size?
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah, it's 7 a.m., 11:30, 3 p.m., 6:30, and 7:30. So there is plenty of option for you not to miss the, a session. And the best part is even if you want to do it morning, evening, the subscription allows you to do as many sessions as you want from Monday to Friday in these times. So you want, it's not a batch-wise system. It's a subscription-based system which is there. So now in terms of the special price which we you can get this, all this is that only the original price was $12.49, and we've started to offer it an introductory price of $6.99, but now for next for these webinar attendees, the special price is only ₹525. And 525 for the entire month. And what you will get in this 525 is the subscription for live classes a month, the subscription to Eka app, which is priced, I think, ₹200 a month. So that is in addition to the live subscription, which you will get. And obviously you become part of a meditative, meditation student community. So there are a lot of community benefits. Eka keeps on doing some special sessions for their community. So that option will always be also be there with you. And we all with Eka has also developed then a self-paced e-learning program, especially on anxiety relief. Where Dr. Meghna, who is an expert psychologist, have also offered some invaluable sessions in it. So that is priced at ₹799 if you want to buy. That's a 1 year subscription you get, 1 year access you get with that course. And if you want to get both the options of 1 month Eka subscription and 1 year e-learning program, that's being offered to you at a special price of $999 only. So we will display the my colleague Karishma had shared the links for you to make the payment, and this offer is valid for only first 15 participants. So I request you not missing this opportunity. And after that, the price will change to $699. And after 22nd December, we will be moving back to original price of $1249. So that's what we wanted to share about the program. And now we'll be happy to take up any questions you may have with this. Please, you can post in your question, or if there are any questions previously we have missed, then Sudipta can answer. So Sudipta, you want, is there any question? Please put in your questions, which can be
also feedback. And one question was about a specific neck issue, which, you know, if they come for the class, then every week, every class, we address different areas of the body. Like, you know, we do the neck sizes, shoulder, upper back, chest, the entire spine, hips. So depending on the day, you'll get to experience different types of movements. And then that asana you can use on a regular basis, whatever gives you the most comfort. And also, if you ask the teacher in class, after class, then, you know, in the next class, the teacher can include it so that you can get the practice. It is still a group class, so we have to keep in mind everyone's you know, needs. But you can definitely ask us questions after the class, and we will make sure that we address it through the week, that week.
Okay, sure. Thanks. If there's any other question regarding the course, you can put in the chat, and we will be concluding the session in next 2 minutes. So please type in, and if any question you have about the live session, Sudipta and myself are there to answer the queries. And we will be posting the links also in the WhatsApp group, of which you all are part of. We look forward that for everyone to make sure that it's doesn't whatever experience you had today, it's something which you get on daily basis. That's when the real benefit will come. So
exactly, why, you have to build a habit. That's the key.
So thanks, everyone. We'll be now closing the session. We'll share the session recording. And thanks, everyone, for taking time out. Thanks, Sudipta, for offering the session today to the participants. And we look forward. Thank you. Thanks.